Have you ever walked out of a movie theater so impressed by the audio experience that you forgot all about the 30 bucks you just dropped on popcorn and soda and could only think about how you wish the sound could surround you at home? So you run down to your local big box store and start looking for home theater equipment, but pretty soon, you're thrust into a disorienting vortex of numbers and dots like 7.1 and 5.1.2. So let's break down what these numbers mean. The first number you see in a surround setup simply refers to the number of channels. Usually, this refers to the number of regular speakers in your system. So a conventional 5.1 system will typically have 5 speakers: front left, center, front right, surround left, and surround right. Each channel can receive a separate audio signal. So if you're watching a movie that has its audio encoded in 5.1 surround, the source will likely send dialogue to the center speaker, while the other speakers will play audio relative to the action on the screen for a more realistic and immersive experience. By contrast, a 2.0 system simply indicates a plain old straightforward stereo setup with a left and a right channel only, while 7.1 indicates 2 additional rear channels above a normal 5.1 for greater immersion. But what does that 0.1 mean? The second number indicates a low frequency effects, or LFE channel, which would be reproduced with a subwoofer. You see, the woofers on a regular speaker typically aren't large enough or powerful enough to accurately reproduce very low frequency or low end sounds, which is why subwoofers are so often paired with speaker sets. If you've ever used a subwoofer, you'll know it only reproduces sub bass, so it's broken out as a separate 0.1 to indicate that it's not a normal speaker. For an even better experience, you might see 0.2, maybe even 0.4, to indicate that the system supports 2 or more subwoofers for extra bass or for a little more spatial accuracy. Now, you won't always see a third number to describe a surround setup, especially as that convention is a little newer. But if it is included, this indicates overhead or height channels, such as ceiling mounted or in ceiling speakers. 3 numbers typically indicate that it's a system that supports an object-based surround sound protocol like Dolby Atmos or DTS:X, where sounds are recorded as individual objects in 3D space instead of simple channels. And if that sounds confusing, never fear, because you can learn all about Atmos in this video. Okay, now you know what the numbers mean, but there are a few other points to keep in mind before you rush out to buy a new home theater setup. Remember that the numbers represent channels, not speakers. And while each channel does usually get 1 physical speaker unit, a major exception is the ever popular soundbar. It's quite easy to find 2.1 soundbars that contain 2 separate sets of drivers for your left and right channels, as well as a built-in subwoofer. So even though 2.1 might make you think of 3 separate speakers in the box, that isn't always the case. Similarly, the third number is present in setups that have no actual overhead speakers. Instead, there are upward firing speakers that are either built into soundbars or sit on top of your existing speakers that bounce sound off your ceiling to simulate sounds coming from above you, with mixed results. Another important tip for the best experience is that the source material should be encoded in a way that matches your speaker setup. Although object-based schemes like Atmos can scale to different numbers of speakers, all the way up to 64, there's lots of content that's specifically encoded for 5.1 or 7.1. But don't worry if the encoding doesn't match your setup exactly, because for example, modern receivers can easily downmix the 7.1 signal to work on just 2 surround speakers if you have a 5.1 setup, or upmixing a 5.1 signal to 7.1 home theater can also be done with software trickery like Dolby Pro Logic 2X, which is found on most modern receivers and can analyze the audio signal to figure out what sound should be coming out of what speaker and when. Or you could forget all of this stuff and just use the speakers built into your TV. I mean, they at least function, right? Check out Private Internet Access VPN, which masks your true IP address and encrypts your traffic with reliable service and no bandwidth caps. It has configurable encryption and an internet kill switch, which keeps you in control of your connection. You can combine PIA with private browsing and make websites think that you're in a different country. Plus, you can connect up to 10 devices at once with clients for Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, and Linux. PIA has also recently launched its new dedicated IP option, which offers an even smoother internet experience while maintaining your privacy and security. With over 25,000 servers in 77 countries, what are you waiting for? Try PIA risk-free for 30 days at the link below. So thanks for watching, guys. If you liked this video, like it, subscribe, and hit us up in the comment section with your suggestions for topics that we should cover in the future.